5. George and Ken review the course they had followed 11 years before.
Here, and the Kittiwakes are there.
All this country is really nice. This is pretty up this way, big glacial valley.
There's hot springs here. Uh-huh. There's hot springs here. There's hot springs there. There's hot springs here.
Oh, there's
hot
so many.
The United States National Weather Service forecast for Western Washington, cooler days.
At 6 o'clock the next morning, final preparations were made. On this trip, we would head 900 miles north to Torch Bay with the help of a diesel-powered ketch. The kayak journey would begin from there, following the original course in a three-week trip south to Hansen Island. At 7 o'clock, we set sail. The Starship and the Canoe, Chapter 12. The treehouse is not home to George Dyson. He thinks of his Douglas fir as the anteroom to a much larger dwelling. The entire Inside Passage province, the 900 miles of protected waters from the southern end of Vancouver Island to Glacier Bay in Alaska, is George's place. He would like to build rooms here and there all along that coast.
Well, I think everybody has, you know, some of the sea captain that just like to be at the wheel. And if I was saying, if Ken had not written that book about me that encouraged me so much to keep building canoes, I think this is what I wanted to do with my life.
I never heard that from George before. I'm glad. Yeah.
At one time, the entire Inside Passage was covered by the Cordilleran ice sheet, which in grinding its way over George's country, carved the final touches upon it. The glaciers were enormous, and so are the land and seascapes they left behind. The fjords are deep and labyrinthine. The landforms are all out of scale, belonging on a larger planet. It is a country shaped by water. Heavy rainfall dark greened it. Fog grooved the needles of the conifers and tipped the guard hairs of the wolves. Cold stream currents thickened the pelts of the mink and otter, fattened the grizzlies, streamlined and silvered the flanks of the trout, chambered the salmon's indomitable, homeward leaping heart. The skies above the Inside Passage belong above a more vaporous planet, like Venus. Clouds boil up from the cold cauldron of the North Pacific, white against the high gray.
There, Alaska, British Columbia. I think we're just about there.
Okay. Hi.
We got a toast. What is it to? Alaska?
Yeah.
Come by.
And to the Virginia Hope.
Yeah.
Virginia Hope.
I give you the Starship and the Canoe. Virginia Hope on the road has a nice day.
Very nice day. Yeah.
We arrived at Gustavus on August 13th. This was our first landing since leaving Vancouver. We had come to pick up the kayak that George and Ken had used on their journey 11 years before. We walked the 4 miles to Marty Yeager's house.
I wandered so aimless, life filled with sin. I wouldn't let my dear Savior in. Then Jesus came like a stranger in the night. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the
light. Bugs inside, George. I saw the light. Us and some spiders.
No more darkness.
I can't believe I used to carry that.
Now I'm so happy, no sorrow.
George made this kayak in 1972, the same year that Freeman was in Europe, lecturing on the possibilities of human colonies on the comets.
Marty Yeager? Ken Brown, are you the
I'm the scientist. Hey, where's your girlfriend still in Vancouver, George?
Yeah, we're getting married on September 21st.
I'll be damned.
For George, much of that year was spent on the sounds and fjords of the Inside Passage in his newly constructed three-man Baidarka. Based on designs borrowed from the hide-covered canoes of the Aleuts, George's kayak slipped silently along the coast. His companions were whales and ravens. He had not seen or heard from his father in 6 years. We left Gustavus at 2 p.m. With luck and good weather, we would reach Torch Bay before nightfall.
Yes. No, I believe that. I really believe that quite strongly. That this planet is getting too small for us. There are too many people on this planet. And we have really only...